Hello students, welcome to the new session of physiology, which is edema. When you will go for your clinical practice, you will find number of patients with edema. And now today in this lecture, we will see that edema has got number of causes. Edema is just a sign. One has to evaluate totally in detail to know what is the cause of edema. Then only the proper treatment can be given and then only the patient can get relief. What is definition of edema? Edema is collection of fluid in a tissue spaces. Either it can be a intracellular edema, that means the collection of the fluid is there mainly in the intracellular compartment, which is less common compared to that of the extracellular edema. In that case, it is the collection of fluid in the extracellular compartment, that is mainly in the interstitium, which is much more common. Now, what are the causes of edema? To understand the causes of edema, first we have to understand what causes the filtration at the capillary end, then what causes the absorption at the venous end of the capillary. So, just to revise for you, let us see that this is the arterial end of the capillary and this is the venous end of the capillary. And these are the cells. This phase will be called as interstitium, right? Now, what will happen at the arterial end of the capillary? Some fluid, that is the mainly the plasma minus plasma protein, that will be filtered. What causes this filtration? Because of the Starling's forces. What are the Starling forces? Can you revise with me? Remember, the hydrostatic pressure in the capillaries. Now, just analyze the hydrostatic pressure in the capillaries, whether it is going to favor the filtration or it is going to oppose the filtration. Hydrostatic pressure means what? The number of molecules which are bombarded over the lateral walls, that is equal to the mean capillary pressure. So what will happen? The number of molecules they are bombarding over the wall, and this capillary has got the pores, right? So what will happen because of that? That is going to favor the filtration, the hydrostatic pressure of the capillaries. Next, the plasma contains plasma proteins, or the blood contains plasma proteins. Now, this plasma proteins, which most important being the albumin because of the number of it, this plasma proteins will have the osmotic effect. This plasma proteins will try to repel, or it will not favor the filtration. They will try to hold the fluid with them. So this is called as the oncotic pressure, the osmotic pressure of the plasma protein, which is called as the oncotic pressure, right? Next, there is some hydrostatic pressure in the interstitium also. Now, if you recall, the interstitial fluid is normally drained by the lymphatics. And the lymphatics maintains this interstitial hydrostatic pressure to a negative value. This negative interstitial hydrostatic pressure is going to favor the filtration because it is negative. It will have the suction effect. So it will try to suck the fluid from the capillaries. If it becomes positive, imagine, suppose this fluid is drained by the lymphatics. If there is a lymphatic blockage, what will happen? The fluid will get accumulated here. And naturally now, this negative interstitial fluid will become positive. Once it becomes positive now, it will not favor the filtration, but it is going to oppose the filtration, right? So the interstitial fluid hydrostatic pressure, if it is negative, it is going to favor the filtration. If it becomes positive, it is going to oppose the filtration. Normally the plasma proteins, they are not filtered or they are not filtered through the capillaries. But some plasma proteins might be present in the interstitium, which are again drained by the lymphatics. So these plasma proteins which are present in the interstitium, they will have the osmotic effect and they will try to absorb the fluid from the capillaries. So now what are the factors which will favor the filtration? The hydrostatic pressure in the capillaries, that is the negative interstitial hydrostatic pressure in the interstitium, and the oncotic pressure of the plasma protein present in the interstitium. What are the factors which are going to oppose the filtration? That is the oncotic pressure of the plasma proteins in the capillaries. But the net balance at the capillary end, or the arterial end here, is towards filtration. So therefore the fluid will be filtered here, which is rich in oxygen, which is rich in the glucose. And there is a fluid which is being absorbed at the venous end. Now, what causes this absorption? because the balance will shift towards now the absorption here. Because the hydrostatic pressure of the capillaries, since some fluid is being filtered out now, the hydrostatic pressure will significantly decrease. Whereas the oncotic pressure, since the plasma proteins are not filtered, it will remain same. So the hydrostatic pressure will be decreased, the oncotic pressure is going to be same, now the balance is shifted towards the absorption. So some fluid is being absorbed here. So if you understand this basic mechanisms of the Starling forces, to understand the causes of edema, it will be easy for you. Let us now first start with the revision that what causes intracellular edema. As you can see in this slide, what are the causes of intracellular edema? First, decreased metabolic activity. Next is hyponatremia. And next is inflammation. Let us try to understand each point in detail. How does the decreased metabolic activity can cause intracellular edema? Remember that the cell membrane has got one active pump, which is much more dependent on the oxygen supply. And this active pump is sodium potassium ATPase pump. And now, can you tell me what is the function of sodium potassium ATPase pump? Yes, you are right. What the sodium potassium ATPase pump will do? It will take three sodium ions from inside the cell, it will put it outside in exchange of two potassium ions which will go inside. And for that it will use ATP, that means energy, and it will require continuous oxygen supply. So if the metabolic activity, let us say that some tissue is having ischemia, that is decreased blood supply. Decreased blood supply means decreased oxygen. Decreased oxygen means what will happen now? Decreased activity of sodium potassium ATPase pump. So naturally, if the sodium potassium ATPase pump activity is decreased, more and more sodium is going to be accumulated inside the cell. More and more potassium will be accumulated outside the cell. And what is the property of the sodium? Sodium has got the osmotic effect. Sodium has got the osmotic effect. That means it is going to hold water with it. So what will happen after some time? If more and more sodium is going to be inside the cell, it will hold water with it, and naturally the size of the cell will increase. Swelling will take place. And ultimately this will call it as the intracellular edema. So what is number one cause of edema? Decrease in metabolic activity. Either it can be due to ischemia or it can be due to some toxic effect. Ultimately, that is going to affect the sodium potassium ATPase pump, and it is going to cause the edema. Next cause is hyponatremia. That will also cause the intracellular edema. Just in the previous lecture, we have seen that hyponatremia means what will happen? The osmolarity of the extracellular fluid will decrease. So if the osmolarity of the extracellular fluid is decreased, the intracellular osmolarity is same, naturally there will be endosmosis. Water from the extracellular fluid compartment will move into the intracellular fluid compartment, and the size of the cell will increase. Next cause of the intracellular edema is inflammation. What happens in inflammation? Inflammation will cause increase in the permeability, cellular membrane permeability. So if there is an increase in cellular membrane permeability, naturally more and more fluid will go inside the cell, and ultimately it is going to cause edema. So these are the few causes of the intracellular edema, which is much more less common compared to that of the extracellular fluid edema. So therefore, we will try to understand in detail now what are the causes of extracellular fluid edema. If you recall the Starling forces now, so what will be the causes of extracellular fluid edema? Increase in capillary filtration. That means if there is a more filtration that is occurring at the capillaries, or blockage of lymphatic drainage. Whatever the fluid, it has been filtered now, some of the fluid is taken by the lymphatic system. So if there is a blockage to the lymphatic system, that even can cause extracellular edema. Let us try to understand in detail this equation. What is the capillary filtration? On what factors it is determined by? Just look at this equation. Capillary filtration is equal to the capillary filtration coefficient, that is, this is the Kf, multiplied by the HPC. What is HPC? Hydrostatic pressure in the capillaries minus hydrostatic pressure in the interstitial fluid. This whole minus oncotic pressure of the capillaries minus oncotic pressure of the interstitial fluid. This is just whatever I have explained. You have put it in the equation form. On what factors the capillary filtration coefficient depends? It depends upon the capillary permeability and the surface area. So the capillary filtration coefficient, that will differ from capillary to capillary, and even it will depend from situation to situation. If the membrane is having ischemia, that means the capillary filtration coefficient will increase. But some of the capillaries, they have got fenestrae. That means more porous. They are more porous. So in that case, the capillary filtration coefficient is going to be increased. But more importantly, you have to understand this hydrostatic pressure and the oncotic pressure. So according to this equation, the capillary filtration, it is mainly hydrostatic pressure in the capillaries minus hydrostatic pressure in the interstitial fluid. But the hydrostatic pressure in the interstitial fluid is negative. So this 2 negative will become positive. If at all, this is negative here. Oncotic pressure will depend upon the plasma protein. As you can see in this now, filtration will increase. In which cases? If there is increase in the capillary filtration coefficient. Just now I explained, in case of inflammation, the permeability of the cell membrane or the permeability of the capillaries, that is going to be increased. So therefore there is increase in the capillary filtration coefficient. In case of burns also, the vessels will dilate, the capillaries will dilate, and ultimately they are going to cause more of the fluid to be filtered out. Ultimately, it is going to cause edema. In case of heat, which is going to dilate the vessels. Ischemia, which is going to dilate the vessels. So, all this will increase the capillary filtration coefficient and ultimately the more capillary filtration, and it will cause edema. Whereas filtration will also increase if there is an increase in the hydrostatic pressure of the capillaries. Now, in case of heart failure, in case of heart failure, the hydrostatic pressure of the capillaries is going to increase? For that, you have to understand, if there is a heart failure, let us say that there is a right ventricular failure. So, if there is a right ventricular failure, more and more fluid will accumulate in the right ventricle. It will cause backward pressure in the right atrium. From the right atrium, the backward pressure will go into the superior vena cava and the inferior vena cava. Ultimately, the pressure, the hydrostatic pressure at the venous end, it is going to increase. Even at the arterial end, it is going to increase. Naturally, what it is going to cause? It is going to cause, if it is hydrostatic pressure is increased at the arterial end, more filtration. If the hydrostatic pressure is increased at the venous end, less absorption. What is the end result? The more fluid that will get accumulated in the tissue fluid, that will be the edema. Similar things will happen if there is a venous obstruction. Venous obstruction will also cause the edema. Decrease in plasma protein, which can occur in number of the clinical situations, that is even going to cause edema. Nephrotic syndrome, we will see in detail. Plasma proteins, they are normally should not be filtered at the glomerular capillaries, but they are filtered and excreted into the urine. So what will happen because of that? The concentration of the plasma proteins will decrease. If the plasma protein concentration is decreased, the oncotic pressure at the capillaries will decrease, and ultimately the force which is going to oppose the filtration, that will become less. So the more fluid will be filtered, and ultimately it is going to cause edema. In liver diseases, the plasma proteins are synthesized less. So therefore, it is going to cause decrease in the oncotic pressure, and ultimately it is going to cause the edema. Next important cause of the edema is the lymphatic failure or even lymphatic obstruction. Now, how it is going to cause the edema? If at all there is a lymphatic obstruction, the two things will result. The fluid from the interstitium, it will not be drained by the lymphatics. So what will happen? Normally the interstitial hydrostatic pressure, which is negative, it will turn into a positive value. And now if it turns into a positive value, it is going to oppose the filtration. Not only that, but another function of the lymphatics is that the plasma proteins, which are also being taken away by the some of the plasma proteins which are filtered through the and it they go into the interstitium, they are taken away by the lymphatics. So if they are not being taken away, plasma proteins will remain in the interstitium, and they will have the osmotic effect, and they will cause more filtration, that means edema. So because of this, there is more accumulation of the plasma proteins, and the hydrostatic pressure is going to be becoming positive, lymphatic obstruction will cause edema. What are the examples where the lymphatic obstructions can be seen? Infection by the filariasis or elephantiasis. That is a common thing you might have seen, at least in some of the patients, or at least in the pictures in your book. So this remains a common cause of the lymphatic obstruction, filaria. These worms will block the lymphatic channels. Cancer means the metastasis of the cells. they will go and then ultimately they are being taken away by the lymphatics and they will cause the blockage of the lymphatics. Cancer patients, they have to go for the, if there is a metastasis, they will have to go for the surgery and the draining lymph nodes, they are being removed, or the lymphatic channels, they are being removed. This removal of the lymphatics, ultimately it is going to cause the obstruction to the lymphatic drainage, and that part of the, that's the one which is being drained by those lymphatic group or the lymph nodes, that part will have edema. So now if you understood this much, let's go into the details, because this is very important for you. A number of multiple choice questions that can be asked in related to that. What are the causes of edema and what is the basis of generation of edema in each cause? So just be with me and try to analyze how each and every cause can cause, that can generate edema. Let's see the number one cause: excessive kidney retention of salt and water. This can happen in kidney failure. Remember, one of the important function of the kidney is to regulate the body volume. If the intake of the water is more, the loss of water is not in proportion to that. Ultimately, more water will accumulate in the body and ultimately that will cause edema. So that will be a generalized edema. So in kidney failure, the person will have generalized edema. Mineralocorticoid excess. Mineralocorticoid means what? Aldosterone excess. If there is aldosterone excess, what is the function of aldosterone? Aldosterone will cause more retention of salt and water, sodium chloride and water with it. So if there is aldosterone excess, if there is a tumor of the adrenal cortex and if there is aldosterone excess, more salt and water that will be retained. So ultimately what will happen? Amount of the body fluid that will go on increasing and the person will have generalized edema in that case, more filtration. Next cause is high venous pressure and venous constriction. That means it is going to increase the hydrostatic pressure at the venous end of the capillary ultimately. So less absorption of the fluid from the tissue and it is going to cause the edema. This can happen in heart failure, which I already explained. Venous obstruction, this can happen in because of the embolus also. Failure of the venous pump, this is commonly seen in varicose veins. That means the walls, they are being failed. So what is the function of these walls? They maintain a unidirectional flow. If the walls are there being failed, more and more blood will get accumulated in the dependent veins. That means the veins of the legs. Ultimately, they are going to increase the hydrostatic pressure of the venous end at the capillary. Paralysis of the muscles. Now, how this is going to cause edema? Remember, one of the important factors to cause movement of the blood in the venous system is the muscles. Your soleus muscle, gastrocnemius muscles. They will act as peripheral hearts. Some veins will be there inside these muscles. Constriction of these muscles is going to pump the blood upside. And ultimately, the walls will make sure that once the blood has been moved, it is not again enters again in the vein back. So if there is a paralysis of the muscle, or if you might have experienced, if you are sitting in a plane for a long time, or if you are sitting in a bus for a long time, what will happen? Your shoes will become, or this will become tight. Why this happens? It is because of the edema. What is the cause of edema here? It is because of the body parts, they are not being mobilized. And the constriction of the muscles, even the pressure of the tissue, surrounding tissue areas, which is the one which is important to make the blood move in, not only in the venous system, but also in the lymphatics. So ultimately, once this is not being moved, that is going to cause the edema. Decrease arterial resistance. How it is going to cause edema? Decrease arterial resistance means what? What offers resistance? Constriction of the arterioles. That will cause the edema. So if the veins, the arteries, they get dilated, that will increase the blood flow. If it increases the blood flow, the hydrostatic pressure at the arterial end of the capillary will increase. If the hydrostatic pressure is increased, it is going to cause more filtration and that will cause the edema. What are the cases in which the arteries can dilate? Excessive body heat, that will dilate the arteries. Insufficiency of the sympathetic nervous system. Remember, the sympathetic tone, that is one which is going to maintain the vasoconstriction. If the sympathetic tone is decreased, the arterioles will get dilated, the blood supply that will going to increase and that will lead to edema. Vasodilator drugs, so they are also going to dilate the arterioles and that will cause the edema. What are the other causes of edema? Loss of proteins in the urine, as we have seen in the nephrotic syndrome. So if the proteins are lost, the oncotic pressure that will is going to decrease. loss of proteins from the denuded skin areas that can happen in the burns in case of wounds. Loss of lot of amount of proteins can be lost. In that case, the oncotic pressure will decrease and the person can have edema. Failure to produce proteins. If the liver, proteins are mainly produced at the liver. So if there is a liver disease such as cirrhosis, the production of the plasma protein that will decrease. If the plasma protein level is decreased, then naturally the oncotic pressure that will decrease. Or even the proteins, plasma protein concentration can decrease even in the malnutrition case. Right? So this remains the cause of edema. Now what are the cause of extracellular edema with the increased capillary permeability? This can happen when if there is an immune reaction. That is the even that can happen in the anaphylactic shock. That is the immune complex reaction that can take place, and because of that histamine is being released, and this histamine will cause severe capillary dilation or vasodilation. The permeability of the capillaries can increase, and because of that the person will have edema. Certain toxins even which will cause capillary dilation or the vessels will dilate. Bacterial infection will have the similar effect. Vitamin deficiency, especially of vitamin C, which is going to cause vasodilation, increase in permeability and edema. Prolonged ischemia. In response to ischemia, the vessels will dilate because of lack of O2, and again that is going to cause increase in permeability and the edema. Even in case of burns, that even going to cause the edema. What are the causes of edema if there is a blockage to the lymphatic, that is the lymphatic return or the lymphatic drainage? In case of cancer, as I already explained, the metastatic cells will block the lymphatic channels. In case of infection, most commonly the filaria or the elephant's foot, which is going to cause. Surgical removal of the lymphatic channels, that will remain this. Or in some few cases, congenital absence or abnormality of the lymphatic vessels. So, if you see next time now, you have to remember all the causes of the edema in this mind, and then you have to evaluate the patient accordingly. Or in your multiple choice questions, it can be asked that what are the causes of edema, or you have to try to analyze according to the that how this factor is going to increase that can cause the edema. The body has got certain safety mechanism to prevent edema or excess edema. And the whatever the swellings we see is only after that safety mechanism that has been crossed. How is the safety mechanism? Just try to look at this slide and try to understand. If there is an increased fluid in the interstitium, what will happen? Increase in interstitial hydrostatic pressure. And now this normally, which is this hydrostatic pressure is negative and which is going to cause suction effect. Now it will going to oppose the filtration. So if it is going to oppose the filtration, what will happen at this time? Now the less amount of filtration will take place, and this is how the body will try to prevent the excessive accumulation of the fluid. So decrease in filtration. The next safety factor is increased fluid in the interstitium, increase in interstitial hydrostatic pressure, increase in lymphatic drainage. If the hydrostatic pressure is increased, the lymphatic drainage will increase and the excess accumulation of the fluid in the tissue spaces that will be prevented. Increase in lymphatic flow, ultimately it is going to cause the more of the plasma proteins that will be drained, and ultimately that is even is going to cause the decrease in the interstitial chloriosmotic pressure and decrease in the filtration, right?